After completed that acids and salts pH, today we'll do about some important salt. And first and foremost one which we commonly use daily is common salt, sodium chloride, right? And many products we are going to get it from common salt. So the seawater contains around 2.3 to more than 2% is sodium chloride. So that is, you know, that the seawater is evaporated with to get the common salt, and that common salt is filtered. That is how we get the common salt. This common salt is an important raw material for many products. Like for example, caustic soda, that is sodium hydroxide, baking soda, washing soda, bleaching powder, all these things for which the raw material is sodium chloride. Understood? Common salt, table salt, or commonly we call it as salt, is sodium chloride. In chemical reactions, reaction neutralization between HCl and NaOH will give you sodium chloride. That is it. But otherwise, it's a natural substance extracted from the seawater or maybe from the rock salt in certain places like Sambar Lake and etc. Where it is found as such, the common salt is taken out. Normally, 2.6 to 3% is a common salt present in seawater, and from which we isolate the common salt by evaporation. That is how we get it. Now, one such product we get it from the common salt is caustic soda. So that process is known as flow alkali process. Flow alkali. That means there are two things. One is alkali, that is NaOH, and the second one is chlorine. So the manufacture of chlorine along with alkali is known as flow alkali process. And how this flow alkali process is carried out? What is it? The concentrated solution of NaCl is electrolyzed. NaCl concentrated solution of NaCl is known as brine. You know that some of the chemicals, what it is written, it is preserved in brine. So brine is concentrated sodium chloride solution. So what we are taking it? We are taking concentrated sodium chloride, and that sodium chloride solution in that NaCl is contained. And aqueous solution of common salt is a good electrolyte. When electricity is passed, for the time being, I remove this. So, we are studying what is electrolysis. The electrolysis of sodium chloride will give sodium and chlorine. Understood? Electrolysis of sodium chloride will be sodium and chlorine. We have studied it earlier. The norm, the metals will be collected at cathode. So, chlorine metal is being collected at cathode. And chlorine will be collected at cathode. So the three electrolyte cell, it will be on cathode as well as anode. Cathode is connected to the negative terminal, anode is connected to the positive terminal. So the electropositive metals, all metals are electropositive, they get collected at cathode. And all non-metals are electronegative, they get collected at cathode. So chlorine is in glass, which get collected at anode. Understood clearly? Now what we have is sodium is there. And you know that we are studying sodium is a hydroelectric so reactor with the smoke. Sodium gets reacted with water and we need sodium hydroxide and hydrogen. So what has happened? So during the process of electrolysis of aqueous solution sodium chloride, the chlorine gas is collected at anode. Understood it clearly? And the sodium is getting collected at cathode. And the sodium metal is reacted with water, we get sodium hydroxide and hydrogen. So where do we get? The hydrogen is connected at cathode, caustic soda is around cathode, and chlorine is connected at cathode. Understood clearly? And this process is known as flow alkali process. Why is it called flow alkali process? We get chlorine, stands for chlorine, and NaOH is an alkali. So flow alkali process is the electrolysis of aqueous solution of or concentrated solution of sodium chloride to give three important products. One is caustic soda, second one is chlorine, and the third is hydrogen. All these three products obtained are important. Now remember, chlorine is getting collected at anode. Sodium is getting formed on the cathode. So it reacts with the water to produce caustic soda and hydrogen. So hydrogen is getting collected at cathode, chlorine is getting collected at anode, and the solution turned out to be caustic soda. Understood it clearly? This process is known as chloralkali process. All right. Now, the important uses of all these things, important uses of, like, first is caustic soda or sodium hydroxide. It is a deliquescent solid. You know that deliquescence is the property of the material to absorb moisture and becomes wet. So sodium chloride, sorry, caustic soda is a deliquescent solid, crystalline in nature, but also when you take it out from the bottle, it absorbs moisture and becomes wet. It is readily soluble in water, and when sodium hydroxide dissolves in water, it is highly exothermic. Remember, all dilutions are done by adding the thing into water, not water into this one. So it is highly exothermic. Sodium chloride, caustic soda, you know that the reaction of neutralization. An alkali can be neutralized only by an acid. So when caustic soda is reacted by an acid, we will be getting neutral salt, any acid. If it is HCl is used, we get sodium chloride and water. SuSO4 is used, we get sodium sulfate and water. Understood? Most of the caustic soda, when it is exposed, it absorbs moisture and becomes wet. Otherwise, it will absorb carbon dioxide and forms a whitish coating of sodium carbonate over it. That is the secondary one. Understood clearly? It is soapy to touch. You know that when you touch it, it has the feeling of touching the soap. Uses of sodium hydroxide. It is used in the manufacture of soaps and detergents. The major constituent of soaps and detergents which are manufactured by using caustic soda. It is used in the manufacture of artificial silk, which is known as rayon, and paper. You have studied in the lower classes how this rayon is prepared. It is dissolved, the wood pulp is dissolved in caustic soda, and from which it is further manufactured. It is used as a degreasing agent. Degreasing agent means, you know that we have these, chimneys at our home, kitchen chimneys, that will be getting stuck with a lot of oil. So that oil gets cleaned only by the caustic soda. It is used as a degreasing agent. Because when caustic soda is reacted by oil, it forms a soapy material. That is the reason. So it is used degreasing the metals. It is used in the petroleum refining. It is used in textile industry. It is used in purification of bauxite. Bauxite is an ore of aluminium. Aluminium ore is concentrated by dissolving it in caustic soda. Al2O3, when dissolved in water, it will be producing sodium aluminate. Sodium aluminate is a soluble compound. Therefore, it is used in that. These all are the uses. The next one, uses of chlorine. It is used as germicide and disinfectant. Chlorine is used, most of the common important use of chlorine is germicide or disinfectant. To kill the germs and bacteria present in water, chlorine is used. Understood it? Chlorine is also used, the basic purpose of chlorine has got two uses. One is to disinfect, kill the germs, and the second one is bleaching purposes. These are the two important applications of bleaching powder. Whatever it is, you say that water is purified, the swimming pool, water is clean, and all these things. The chlorine, when it reacts with water, it generates active oxygen. And that oxygen does all the functions. Understood it? If you put bleaching powder into water, that will be generating active oxygen. So chlorine's basic two important. One is to disinfect with water, and the second is bleaching powder. And it is also used in the manufacture of PVC, polyvinyl chloride, CFC, chloroform, etc. Chloroform, you know that anesthesia purpose it is used, CaCl3, that contains chlorine. PVC contain, it is a polymer of vinyl chloride, and then chlorofluorocarbons. Nowadays it is banned in developed countries. So developing countries still they use CFC, chlorofluorocarbons, as a refrigerant fluid. So for that manufacture it is used. Bleaching powder means what is its function? To bleach or kill the germs. It is one other function, the same. And the manufacture of pesticides, it is used. Then hydrogen, you know that it is used as an industrial fuel, not as a domestic fuel. Why hydrogen cannot be used as a domestic fuel? Simple reason is, hydrogen is explosive in nature. The rate of combustion of hydrogen is very high. The rate of combustion of hydrogen being very high, that leads to explosion.
So hydrogen is explosive, therefore it is used as, it is not used as a domestic fuel, whereas industrially it is used as a fuel. And it is used in the manufacture of vanaspati, vegetable ghee. Like, you know, unsaturated fat is oil. Oil, any oil. Through which, with the presence of a catalyst and you pass hydrogen, then it gets converted into solid fat. Like, you know, the dalda and etc. So these are vanaspati ghee, which is being prepared from oil. So hydrogen is all, it is not good for our body. You can ask the doctor, they say that unsaturated oil is good for the body. Saturated fat is not good for the body. So that saturated fat, saturated one is prepared by passing hydrogen through this. Understood clearly? And in the manufacture of fertilizers and etc. Rocket fuel, it is used. Two products of hydrogen combined above. HCl, that is also here. The next one is hydrochloric acid. You know that it is used for cleaning steel, it is used for preparation of ammonium chloride, cosmetics and medicines, textiles, dyeing, tannins, making plastics, polyvinyl chloride, and everywhere it is used. Have you understood it? This is about the common use. Now what we are going to do is the manufacture of baking soda. The next one, see, baking soda is, we prepare it from, baking soda get prepared from sodium chloride. Understood it clearly? So how we carry out this means, the raw material is needed or the reaction what is likely to take place in this way. NS3, that is ammonia plus H2O plus carbon dioxide. All these are in the form of gas. So in the pressurized form, when they are combining, we'll be getting ammonium bicarbonate, NS4, HCO, ammonium bicarbonate is obtained. Understood? So one of the products that we need to manufacture is like ammonia is prepared artificially, carbon dioxide, water is taken, and carbon dioxide is used to react with ammonium bicarbonate. And then this ammonium bicarbonate, reacting with sodium chloride, we'll be getting sodium bicarbonate plus So next step, what is done? All these three reactions, this plus this one. NS3, H2O, carbon dioxide, NaCl will be NaCl plus NaCl. So how the reaction takes place is this way. Ammonia combines with water and carbon dioxide to produce ammonium bicarbonate. And that ammonium bicarbonate gets reacted with sodium chloride, will be getting sodium bicarbonate and ammonium chloride. This is how baking soda is prepared. Understood? Now, this is not part of the sense, otherwise I would have told you how this ammonia is prepared. Understood? Ammonia, we prepare it. The raw material needed for the manufacture of ammonia is ammonium chloride. So what are the raw materials needed for the manufacture of baking soda is this one, ammonium chloride. This is the one artificial one is used. And the second one is coke, and the third is sodium chloride plus this. And then limestone, calcium carbonate. So how the reaction takes place is this way. When calcium carbonate is heated, we get calcium oxide and carbon dioxide. And calcium oxide combines with H2O, we get calcium hydroxide. So now what takes place is, calcium hydroxide will be reacted with ammonium chloride. Calcium hydroxide reacted with NH4Cl to produce calcium chloride plus H2O plus NaCl. This is ammonia that is produced. So what is the beauty of this reaction is, all the raw materials what we use, ammonium chloride is the only one which is artificially one. This is the first layer. Coke is cold. Sodium chloride, seawater, and calcium carbonate, marble. So all these are materials are very cheap. And the only one what we use mostly is ammonium chloride. And you can understand, during the manufacture process, ammonium chloride will not be used. Understood? Ammonium chloride is not consumed. We need it by the ammonium chloride. So that is the beauty of the reaction. So what can we say that now, you can understand it, we got ammonia, we got water, we got carbon dioxide, and all these things ammonium bicarbonate, and ammonium bicarbonate plus sodium chloride will be sodium bicarbonate plus ammonium chloride. So The important raw material that we are use ammonium chloride is obtained by. Understood it? The precipitated sodium bicarbonate filtered and dried, it is understood it? And when it is strongly heated, the water molecules present is lost and we get sodium solidified, ignited to get sodium carbonate. Now, how do we prepare washing soda from baking soda? We have studied long time by thermal decomposition. When any bicarbonate is heated, when NaCO3 is forming heater, we will be getting Na2CO3 plus H2O plus carbon dioxide. This is how washing soda is prepared. So both the manufacturers are ready. What I mean to say that first we produce baking soda. Baking soda is prepared by how we produce baking soda. Ammonium chloride is getting reacted with. Ammonium chloride reacted with calcium hydroxide, we get ammonia. So ammonia plus carbon dioxide plus H2O, we'll be getting ammonium bicarbonate, NH4SCO3. And NH4SCO3 plus sodium chloride will give you NaCO3 plus NH4Cl. And NH4Cl is the one what I told you, costly material which we get it back. And then sodium bicarbonate is obtained. On heating sodium bicarbonate, we get washing soda. So washing soda is obtained by strongly heating of sodium bicarbonate. Understood it clearly? The next one is, it is soluble in water, aqueous solution is alkaline, therefore it is used as antacids. Action of heat, I told you, uses of baking soda. You know, the term itself says baking. So all the baking will be having baking soda in it. And what makes baking soda, how does it function? Because first and foremost, one is baking soda when heated. Baking soda when heated, we are getting sodium carbonate, water and carbon dioxide. And the carbon dioxide gas release is the one which makes the cake and fluffy. Understood? So if you don't add baking soda, there was a question asked earlier, your baker had forgotten to add something while the cake is being baked, and he found that the cake found to be very hard. And what made the cake hard? Because if baking soda is not added, then what happens? The thing is going to become hard. Now, how baking soda makes it soft? When baking soda is heated, it is releasing carbon dioxide. So, through the batter, when carbon dioxide gases melt and off, it makes it soft. So, that is a function of baking soda. But there is a drawback. This is washing soda, that is a product obtained in the heating of baking soda. So, this washing soda is thicker in taste. Understood? Therefore, if you bake your cake only with baking soda, then the cake will taste like that of soap. So neutralize the taste of washing soda. What is added? The baking powder contains an edible acid. Any edible acid is added. So that what happens when the acid gets reacted with the sodium carbonate, that also makes the thing more fluffy and the bitter taste of washing soda is neutralized. So there is a question, what is the difference between baking soda and baking powder? Have you understood the difference? Baking soda is only sodium bicarbonate. And baking powder contains sodium bicarbonate plus an edible acid. And what is the function of edible acid in it? Edible acid is to neutralize the taste of washing soda that is produced. Understood it clearly? Baking soda is also used in fire extinguishers. You know that in case of small fire, electrical fire, take a little bit of baking soda and throw it onto the fire. How does the fire get extinguished? On heating, baking soda releases carbon dioxide and the fire is getting extinguished by the presence of carbon dioxide. Carbon dioxide being heavier, it covers the burning substance, cut out the supply of oxygen and the fire gets extinguished. So this is how baking soda is used. It is in the use in the manufacture of aerated water, soda water and etc. Used in medicine as antacid. It is used in making baking powder and baking soda. Understood the difference? The next comes sodium carbonate, that is washing soda. Washing soda is also prepared the same process as that of baking soda. NaCl plus H2O plus NS3 plus CO2 will produce sodium bicarbonate plus NH4Cl, and the sodium bicarbonate, when strongly heated, we get washing soda. Understood it? So the washing soda crystals are, washing soda produced is recrystallized to get washing soda crystals. Washing soda is what? Na2CO3.NH2O. Decahydrate sodium carbonate is washing soda. What does it mean? Deca means 10. So what is the difference between soda ash and washing soda? Understood it? Soda ash is when washing soda crystals are heated. When washing soda crystals are heated, the water crystallization is lost. So anhydrous washing soda is soda ash, that is Na2CO3. And washing soda crystals means Na2CO3.NH2O, that is decahydrate sodium carbonate. Understood it clearly? It is soluble in water. Then washing soda is the salt of strong base and weak acid. Therefore, its solution will be alkaline in nature. Understood it? Washing soda crystals are efflorescent. Efflorescent is a property of the crystalline substances to lose water and crumbles to powder. There are two things. One is deliquescence. Deliquescence and efflorescence are opposite to each other. Deliquescence means property of the material to absorb moisture and becomes wet. Property of the material to absorb moisture and become wet, that is deliquescence. And efflorescence is a property by which it loses water of crystallization, crumbled to powder. So washing soda is an efflorescent substance. Understood it? So 9 molecules of water is lost. So anhydrous washing soda is what is known as soda ash. All right? Uses of washing soda. It is one of the common material used in industry. It is used to soften the hard water, to removing permanent hardeners, laundry as a cleaning agent, or the manufacture of soaps and detergents. And you know, laundry people, what happens? They dissolve, they put the cloth in, they will be putting the cloth in washing soda solution. And then they wash it so the cloth gets clean faster. It is used in petroleum refining, sodium compounds like borax, fusion mixture, it is used. Now, what is this fusion mixture? You know that glass is produced by heating sodium carbonate and potassium carbonate strongly. Understood it? So when sodium carbonate and potassium carbonate are heated, it and that mixture is known as fusion mixture, which is used in the manufacture of glasses. Understood it? Glass is a solution of sodium silicate and potassium silicate. Like sodium carbonate on heating will be getting sodium oxide. Potassium carbonate on heating will be getting potassium oxide. And when they combine the silicon dioxide, we get sodium silicate, calcium silicate. And that molten mixture is known as glass. Anyway, that is for the manufactured glass, washing soda is used. The next one is bleaching powder. Bleaching powder is CaOCl2.
Bleaching powder is calcium oxychloride, CaOCl2.
Bleaching powder is calcium oxychloride. Understood it? And how this compound is manufactured?
You know the raw material that is available is limestone. So when we have this calcium carbonate in ether strongly, we get calcium oxide and carbon dioxide. But actually, thermal decomposition. All carbonates will decompose to metallic oxide and carbon dioxide. So we get calcium oxide. Now, this calcium oxide combines with this H2O, we get calcium hydroxide. This is also the first step we are studying. First one is thermal decomposition, and the second one is the reaction combination. Metallic oxide dissolved in water, we get alkalis. Now, calcium hydroxide, to which we pass chlorine, we get calcium oxychloride consistently. This is how the two bodies prepared. Now, in case this is the equation that is given in the book, in case they ask how this compound is manufactured in the raw material, it is better you know it. We have limestone, which are strongly heating, we get calcium oxide. They get combined with water to produce calcium hydroxide, and calcium hydroxide reacts with chlorine, we get calcium oxychloride. So that is how the bleaching powder is prepared. So, simple one line answer. Pass chlorine through calcium oxychloride, we get bleaching powder. Understood it? Pass chlorine through slate lime or calcium hydroxide, bleaching powder is obtained.
Bleaching powder is packed in airtight containers, and there was a question asked, why should bleaching powder container be kept closed? If bleaching powder container is left open, what reaction takes place is
bleaching powder or combines with atmospheric carbon dioxide, and what is something
that is flowing. Understood? So if the bleaching powder packet is left open in atmosphere, then it releases the chlorine gas present in it. Then that bleaching powder is of no use. It is what is left, only calcium carbonate. So that's the reason. Bleaching powder should be kept in airtight containers. If the container is not tight, atmospheric carbon dioxide will react with it and chlorine gas is generated. So then, if the bleaching powder does not have chlorine, then this is of no use. Understood it clearly? The amount of chlorine present in bleaching powder is known as available chlorine. The amount of chlorine present is known as available chlorine. It is expressed as percentage. So a good quality bleaching powder contains around 35 to 39% available chlorine. And if, remember, if the packet is left open, available chlorine will be lesser and lesser, and ultimately what is left is only calcium carbonate. All right. Uses of bleaching powder, you can understand it. Bleaching, the term itself says, it is used for bleaching purpose. All cotton and other heavy materials are bleached in the presence of bleaching powder. Understood it? Disinfectant in water and etc. All right, this is how bleaching powder is manufactured and it is used.